It's one of those days. It's one of those days. So, yeah, it stormed. It stormed like crazy last night. I mean, wow. The wind blew the dumpster off of the stand over here. It's sort of downhill from the entryway at the back, but there's a little stand that's flat for the dumpsters to sit on, and it blew it off the stand and onto its side into the parking lot. I posted pictures on my blog of the snow and what little there was of it. It's more like a freezing sleet that's stuck to everything instead of snow, right? So we got lucky though. We only got high winds and we didn't get a pile of snow, but it's really slippery outside, so it's we're not we didn't go anywhere today because my friend was without power all night and he was worried about it and he didn't sleep, so he didn't want to go for coffee today. So we're gonna go either tomorrow or Saturday. But I had to order something because I'm out of toilet paper. I looked in the closet and I'm like, damn, I thought I had another couple of rolls. No, I don't. So I just used the last bit of my toilet paper and I'm like, oh, dang. So I got just enough. I got the discount brand and just enough to, I didn't want to pay $30 for toilet paper or anything like that to get a huge giant package of it. So I got an 8-pack of double rolls ordered, and that should be coming in the next 2 hours, something like that. So, you know. And of course, there's a $10 minimum, so I had to. I thought I might as well order a couple other things. I got some macaroni and cheese mix, and I got some hot dogs to cut up in the macaroni and cheese mix, and I got a package of taco spice, a hot taco spice that I'm gonna put in the mac and cheese and hot dogs. And that's gonna be dinner tonight. I also wanted some beer, and because I'm gonna be over my credit card limit, and they're gonna nag me anyways. The bank's gonna send me a letter going, "You're over your limit. Pay it now, or we'll kill you." Sort of thing. They don't threaten to kill you. They just threaten to tack on a bunch of interest, basically. But that doesn't go on the card until the 11th of next month, so I'll pay it off well before then. But since I was going to be over anyways, I was thinking, maybe I should order one of those 4-packs of beers. Then I looked at it, and it's going to be like $28 to order 4 beer, and I'm like, that's just insane. So I tacked on to my delivery order from Superstore a 2-liter root beer, so that's gonna have to do. Instead of real beer, it's gonna be root beer. So there we go. Plus, yeah, it's probably slightly better to have the root beer than it is to have the beer anyways. So yeah. Beer is insane in Saskatchewan. It's kind of insane all over Canada, but Saskatchewan in particular, it's insane to buy beer here. And like seriously, before taxes, a 6-pack is like $20. It's just what, it's with some brands, some of them they're $17, $18 for a 6-pack, but yeah, it's just insane, right? It's about $2.20 a can, basically. That's before tax, and there's 15% tax on that, and then there's 10 cents per can deposit that you get back when you cash them in, And there's a 4 cent, no, there's a 6 cent now, 6 cent environmental levy, which is just another tax basically, on each can. So it's a lot of money to get it. So I decided root beer will do, root beer will do. And while I was deciding to do that, I'm going to I got 4 bags of chips, 2 bags of well dressed, 2 bags of dill pickle chips, and I'm gonna have those tomorrow while I'm binging movies. I didn't do my movie marathon yesterday because the power was flaking out and I couldn't watch because the box kept resetting and stuff. And I couldn't do it today because the cable just came on, just now came back on. And my internet's through the cable company, so it just came on now. And I guess I got really super lucky because most of the city was in darkness for like 12 hours. And I got really lucky, 12, 13 hours. I think my friend said he was out for 13 hours. So I got really lucky. Also, we got really lucky with snow because we just got the freezing sleet stuff stuck to everything. My friend that lives on the farm now, she's got 5 feet of snow, and it's not far from here. Like I said the other day, we don't get the precipitation here. We really don't. It goes all around us and just sort of misses us. We get the wind, that's for damn sure. Actually, we get higher winds than everything around us because of the way the land is configured, and it just sort of tunnels through here and picks up speed. But the wind's topped out at 70 miles an hour, actually 68. It was 110 kilometers an hour at 68 point something, so just under 70 miles an hour. And so that's why the bin was on its side. I had to watch because they came to collect the bin, and I never watched them write one of these things before, and it's not like the guy's going to pick it up, right? It's enormous and it's heavy and it's made out of metal. So he's got a chain though, and he hooks the chain on these two chains onto it, and then he lifts it up with the arm. The arms usually go into the sides of the bin, and it goes wee into the back. But and he puts the chains on the things and lifted it up onto its wheels and then put it back with the forks. So that was interesting. I was kind of wondering, and that was pretty much what I thought he would do. Anyways, but it entertained me without cable or internet for 30 seconds or so. The beer I wanted is called Rebellion Brewing Company. I do believe it's local to Saskatchewan or local to Alberta. I'm not sure which one. But it's called Zilla, as in Godzilla. And it was an IPA, and it's like, ooh, that sounds yummy, because I was reading a review somebody posted, and in a group that I'm in, and it was like, ooh, that sounds yummy. So, but yeah, it's not $28 yummy, you know what I mean? Holy cow! But yeah, I'm like $25 over my limit now because I ordered some stuff. And I had to have the toilet paper. I just had to because I'm gonna need it for tomorrow. At the very least, I'm gonna need some for tomorrow. So had to be done, right? Had to be done. And you don't want to be borrowing from people in the building because, COVID and all that crap. So yeah. Oh well, now that my cable's back on though, I'm gonna wait for my groceries, and I'm going to stick my stuff on the stove here, and I'm gonna cook it up, and I'm going to watch at least one of those movies tonight. So, yeah, they're all on Crave TV, which is HBO and a few other things, and Stars, HBO Stars, and some movie thing. I forget the movie thing, Movie Time. I don't remember. All wrapped up into one, and it's also got some Showtime features on it when you use the app. But like I said, the app is toast, and I'm reading it's toast on every platform there is. So yeah, but I have it on the TV, so I can watch. It's part of my cable package. It's $19.99 a month or something, and yeah, so I watch on my HBO and my movies on that. And I want to watch my war movies, dang it. So yeah, anyways, yeah, the ice seems to have melted off my window. There was some, by the way, yeah, the church over here, right? See that building? That's a church. That's the Moose Jaw Church of God. And it's not far away. It's just across the parking lot. It's like 4 car lengths away from me. I couldn't see it last night when the wind was topped out. I couldn't see. That was before my window was covered in ice. I couldn't see well, I took a picture to post online and it didn't come out very well at all. But anyways, I stood up and looked over the ice and I still couldn't see the church. So yeah, that's how bad it was blowing yesterday. So now we're covered in a layer of ice with that's beveled like a curling rink. So this is going to be fun to go for coffee tomorrow. I just hope my friend doesn't fall because I don't know how we're going to get him up. He's my size, which is really, 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 really big. And if he falls, we're not going to be able to pick him up. Me and my other friend aren't going to be able to pick him up for the life of us. And his mother sure as hell isn't going to be able to pick him up. So she's the one driving us, evidently, because my other friend that usually comes with us and drives, her cat died. So she's really sad and she's staying home. And that's really a bummer because she really loves her cats. They're like children to her. I mean, they're children to her, so you know. Anyways, that's it. That's all. I'm gonna turn on the security camera. That's what I was doing for fun today. I was watching the security camera because it's not through the cable box. It's direct feed to the TV. So I was watching that, and there was like, basically, it was just Dilbert driving around in his wheelchair. Because his cable's out, and that's all he does all day is watch cable. So he was bored too. So I actually went down and had a talk with him for a few minutes and checked the mail. Speaking of the mail, the mop left Regina on the 13th, or on the 12th, that is. It's now the 14th. And it's still not out for delivery. And I didn't expect it to be out for delivery today, but I expected it to be out for delivery yesterday. And I don't expect it today because I don't think we're getting mail today. They would be stupid to send out the carriers in this weather right now. They're going to have to get the streets sanded and all this before they can send them out. That's just too much. So, anyways. Have a good day and keep smiling. I just got about a billion texts from the delivery service, so have a good one.